Might also, okay. Aswati has left the meeting, okay. Okay.
You can load and start.
Okay, boss?
Yeah, you can start.
So, good evening, friends. Are you all able to see the screen and hear my voice?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Oh, good, good.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Now, yes, it is. I will use my laser pointer also. So, welcome to the crash course. And today, we are going to give you a lot of insight into treasury operations. I think my voice is okay. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, yeah, yes, sir.
Okay, 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 okay. Friends, remember, treasury is not a function that will be at every branch. It's a specialized activity of a bank, normally centralized at the corporate office. I think all of you are aware of the basic functions. Their basic function is only three. Assets liability management, maintaining SLR, CRR, maintaining liquidity management. That is, liquidity management means excess liquidity they will invest, shortage of liquidity, funds are required, they will borrow. And if the surplus is there, they will investing, borrowing and selling all derivative product, any non-interest income. And they will go on investing the surplus in four markets. What are the four markets? Equity market, that is share markets, very little. Bond market. Bond market means that include government securities also, SLR securities. Because the mandatory, they have to 18% of the NDTL, net demand term liabilities. They have to necessarily invest in secured, that is government of India securities. That is known as SLR, statutory liquidity reserve. That securities is an investment, plus it serves two purposes. It's an investment, income earning investment, very safe investment, and it is earning reasonable assured income for the bank. And it also, they are complying with the regulatory requirements of the Apex Bank, correct? SLR. And CRR they have to maintain. Okay. So this specialized activity that only generates so much profits for the bank, because all of you know now after the NPA issue, loans and advances, there are various critical issues. You are losing your interest income. You have to make provisions. You have to make capital adequacy, capital. Okay. The risk weighted assets, you have to maintain adequate capital. And all this will create a problem in lending. That is also an assets of the bank. But here treasury means whatever surplus they are investing in SLR securities and non-SLR securities. What is SLR? We are going to discuss. What is non-SLR other than SLR? Non-SLR. They will mix up. What is the difference between SLR security and non-SLR? They will invest in, supposing the commercial paper. I think I told there are four markets. These are just 2 minutes. You will understand the basic background of treasury operations. Then only we can go into the subject. Okay. Because the crash course, we will start straight away with the questions. All lively questions, that is likely questions that may be asked. Don't be surprised. These questions may be coming in your next, this forthcoming exam, maybe in a different format. The words may be changed, options will be different, but concepts will remain same, correct? So the first market is equity market, very rarely they invest. There are a lot of regulatory guidelines are there. The second market, they are going to invest in debt market, that is bonds and debentures, they will invest. And here the rate of return will be more in corporate bonds, but in government bonds, rate of return will be less, but safe. Okay, no risk. Risk. You need not have to provide for risk. And so many advantages are there. The third market is money market. Money market only, we because short of the investment you can rotate your money correct faster 1 day to 1 year commercial paper call money market okay cd mean certificate of deposit treasury bills so these short term money market instrument 1 day to 1 year tenor that will give them more because you can quickly rotate your money and this will give more returns more profits for the bank okay friend the fourth market is of course forex market if the rupee funds are more they will convert to dollar and they will invest in dollar or in other currency if dollar funds are more they will swap to rupee and they will invest and they will take care of the interest rate difference okay if they invest in rupee normally they are getting more income more interest I think in international business we discuss that also because every bank wants to generate more non-interest income interest income is becoming a big issue okay friends so this is the background now question number 1 welcome to your crash course so question number 1 we are going to discuss only exam oriented question so the question is liquidity risk of a bank this don't think it's a risk management subject but it's a treasury management because treasury is basically concerned with managing the liquidity of a bank liquidity management what is liquidity it may be under liquidity or it may be over liquidity you are with so much money so many deposits are opened sometimes you know demonetization so many accounts are opened bank will be with lot of money and there is a huge demand slr is increased banks will run out of money then it is a question of what under liquidity over liquidity you are with more money or you are without money so the banks have to manage their liquidity so what is that liquidity risk so that they will give four option you have to read very carefully don't jump and but read carefully and pick up the correct one when maturing assets are less than maturing liability maturing assets are less than maturing liability that mean your assets you have invested your investments you are realizing that cash inflows are less than maturing liability mean outflows you have to pay to the depositor who is withdrawing his deposit so maturing liabilities mean your is an outflow maturing assets mean inflow of funds so here it is known as what this also liquidity risk maturing assets are less than maturing liabilities that is also you are what short of money you have to pay to the depositor but you don't have heavy withdrawals from SB account heavy withdrawals from current account term deposits are getting closed that is okay. A is also liquidity risk second one when maturing assets are more than maturing liability is a positive risk positive gap they are known as it is known as gap maturing assets are more that mean your inflows cash inflows to the bank are more and cash outflows are less now this is also a risk why it's a risk because you are having excess money no excess money have you got by accepting deposit for the depositor you have to give interest and for the it not everything is current account savings bank account also you have to pay some interest term deposit you have to pay some interest you have got huge inflow of funds you have to invest so that also becomes a risk so the correct answer is both situations A and B okay so they will test you liquidity risk mean both becomes a if you don't have money also problem if you have more money also problem sir when I have more money why is the problem no when do you think Reliance Mukesh Ambani is very happy no he has got more assets now how to multiply the assets okay so keeping more money also risk keeping no money also risk understood so this is answer question number 1 very often asked okay question number 2 what's a positive gap in liquidity negative gap positive gap positive gap when you discuss you need not have to worry about negative gap okay they will give options there are 4 options they will give you read the option carefully positive gap means what bank is getting surplus funds in their hands not funds bank is short of funds bank is having more funds that is a positive gap what is a negative gap one negative gap arises maturing liabilities more mean less like maturing assets maturing liabilities more than maturing assets is a negative gap why negative gap heavy withdrawals from your deposits but to that extent there is no repayment of loan or maturing investments are less, so there is a negative gap. When there is a positive gap, you read maturing assets are less than maturing liability. No, it's a negative gap. When maturing assets, okay, so many repayments, that is also assets maturing. Housing loan getting repaid, big term loan getting repaid, that is maturing assets. Or treasury, you have made some investment, due date government bonds, 10,000 crores bonds today due date. So maturing assets more than maturing liability, it's a positive gap. So the answer is either of the situation A, B, no, both situation, oh sorry, here positive gap mean, for the answer I have to change. The positive gap means what? What is positive gap? This is B is the correct answer. Oh, answer is coming now. Answer is B, which is B, maturing assets more than maturing liabilities. Maturing liabilities. Okay, here the interest value you have to ignore. By mistake it has come. Maturing assets mean inflow more. Maturing liabilities mean outflow less. So that means it's a positive gap. Agreed? In balance sheet management, positive gap, interest rate going up. Positive gap, interest rate coming down. Negative gap, interest rate going up. Negative gap, interest rate coming down. Four possible situations I will give you when I discuss the balance sheet related case study. Okay? You understood what is a positive gap, negative gap? Opposite is negative gap. What is negative gap? Maturing liabilities more, maturing assets less. Understood? Maturing liabilities more, then it becomes a negative gap. Positive gap, you understood. The same question, you have to understand other question also. So that any question that are asked in the real exam, because online, you should have clarity of mind. Understood? So question number two, okay. Anytime you free to interrupt, okay. Question number three, what is liquidity risk? Liquidity risk, we have both are liquidity risk. I think both are liquidity risk. Answer D, both situation. If you are having more money also risk, if you are having less money also risk to pay to the depositors, you are running out of funds also risk, flush with more funds also risk. Okay. The fourth one, SLR securities. SLR mean statutory liquidity reserve. As a mandate, statutorily every bank out of 100 rupees deposit, NDTL mean your deposits, current account, savings bank account, term deposit, you are 100% you are mobilizing. The 100 rupees you cannot give loan. You cannot create assets. Loan means it's an asset. So necessarily you have to invest. Right now SLR is 18% and CRR is cash. You have to keep money with the Reserve Bank of India, 3%. So this will be ensured by your treasury room, centralized treasury room, on an ongoing basis. 1 week it was maintained, next week it is not maintained. RBI will levy heavy penalty. Understood? So the SLR securities are very, very important for a bank. And what are the characteristics? Okay, Gunadi Sengal, what are the characteristics? They will give, yes, all the four. Now, questions like this will not be asked in CIB. All the above, none of the above, that sort of questions will not be asked. Please be assured. So the questions, just to know the concept, I have given the question. Low return, yes. High liquidity, yes. Because the government of India, they will not run out of money. If you want to liquidate the investment, you surrender the investment, they will immediately give money. High safety, yes. Low, zero risk, yes. Because the government of India, securities, state government development loan, all are considered. What are SLR security? Just wait. Understood? So these are the four, all the four. So all the above, just to know the concept, I have given the question, but same question will not come. What questions will be in a twisted form, which is not a characteristics of SLR security. You understood? Which is not a characteristics among the following, which you feel is the not a characteristics of SLR security. They will twist you. So when you understand characteristic, you can easily understand which is not a, okay, understood? So this is how in a CAB exam, they will, the questions will be indirect. I think what is direct, what is indirect, we have discussed. Now, what is question number five? I am giving you frequently asked questions. If you are thorough with these 64 questions I am sharing with all of you, I feel you will be able to fare, because the concepts when it is going deep into your mind, any question that may be asked, similar question, okay? These are the questions. How will you get all these questions? Because we interact with the people, okay? So they share with us. That will ultimately help us to develop the question, change the question. Every exam we change depending on what questions are frequently asked. What are the limits used for managing risk in trading deal? Normally, the bank will generate more income in trading deal. What is trading deal? They will buy one treasury bill, okay, or they will sell immediately, because these are all tradable. Some securities they will buy Monday when the prices go up, government bonds. When the prices move up, they will immediately sell. Even any profit, so they will, government security they will not sell, because that is always classified as HTM category. There are three categories that are the assets, the SLR and non-SLR securities are classified into three categories. HTM, we'll come to that. HTM mean held till maturity, other than loans and advances, other than interbank account. These are all income earning. And these income earning treasury assets, your treasury assets, that is maintained by a treasury room, not by individual branches. Individual branches will give only loans and advances, short-term, long-term advances. But the treasury assets will be held by your centralized treasury room. Okay. And there are always classified under SLR, non-SLR. Again, they are reclassified for purpose of trading. They will be classified into, okay, they will be classified into three categories. What are the three categories? If you have got a pen, you write down, note down, because I have not given that. HTM. HTM means held till maturity. Some assets like Government of India bond, treasury bills, they will not sell because they have to maintain that 18% SLR, no, on an ongoing basis. So why to sell this government security? Normally they will not sell. So they are called as what? HTM category, held till maturity category. The next one is AFS category. AFS means available for sale. Some shares they have invested and the share is price is coming down. They will earmark for selling. When the moment the price goes up, they will try to sell. Okay, that is known as what? AFS, available for sale. The next category is HFT, held for trading. That is in another slide, but normally in this crash course, I have not included. That is why I asked you to note down. You understood? HTM securities, normally SLR securities come under what? HTM, held till maturity. AFS, available for sale. That is, if it is likely to lose, they will immediately try to sell. And held for trading, HFT. What is HFT? Held for trading. What is trading? Today they will buy $1 million and tomorrow they will sell. Today they will buy Reliance shares at 800 rupees and tomorrow they will sell at 820 rupees. This is known as what? Trading with securities. Some securities, Forex is also a security. They will buy when the prices are low and they will try to sell when the prices high up, maybe within a day or within a week or within a month. This is known as what? And maximum they can keep up to 90 days. Remember? The HFT, the held for trading, maximum they can keep for 90 days. They need not have to sell immediately. So those securities, okay. So now those securities, there is a limit because it's a risky one. I am buying dollar today or buying not government securities, some shares today, Reliance share, for example, Infosys shares, I am buying today at the rate 1,000. Tomorrow it may become 1,500. Or within a week, it may become 1,500, or it may become 900 also. When it becomes 900, it becomes a loss. So they will keep some limits. What are the limits? Cut loss limit. What is cut loss limit? Separately, you have to understand how much loss, because sometimes treasury, it will result in a loss also because the market is moving in a different way. Nobody is responsible because market movement, you have to, market intelligence is required. Oh, prices are coming down. So before the prices goes down, you should sell the security. So there also limit is there. Deal size. Each deal, you cannot have a maximum $10 million, $100 million, because deal size also important. Because from risk angle, the third is open position. Because sometimes they will buy securities, immediately they will not sell. There may be a gap that is known as open position. The time difference between when you buy, it becomes an exposure for you. It's a risk for you because you are buying at a rate and you have to sell in a higher rate. Buy low, sell high. Then only you will generate profit. Okay. So there also limits are fixed. A and B together. This is a question very often asked to friends. So believe it or not, what are the limits used for managing risk in trading deal? A, B, C, question option D is A and B together.
Okay.
Then option E is A, B, C together. And that seems to be the correct answer. So the answer is E. All the three will be combined. Please remember, cut loss limit, deal size limit, open position limit, all will be used combined because it's a risk for the bank. Understood? Then only bank is safe. Okay. Understood question number 5. So you have to pick up the answer. Cut loss limit, deal size limit, open position limit, all limits will ultimately avoid a huge loss in this trading operation, trading deals. Trading means just to buy when the prices are low, sell when the prices move up. Correct? So you will earn a lot of income. This is question number 5. Question number 6, which is not a SLR? This is a question they will ask you very often. Even last exam, this was the question. Without SLR security, there may not be any question paper. Which is not a SLR? Number 1, cash management bill. Note down, cash management bill is a new instrument introduced by Reserve Bank of India. It's similar to treasury bill. It will be auctioned at the instance of the central government. To manage a temporary short gap in funds, they will auction this CMB. This is known as cash management bill. Note down, it's a treasury bill, but maturity less than 91 days. Note down, treasury bill, normally treasury bill will have three maturities, 91 days, 182 days, 364 days. Only three maturities, they are predetermined maturity, they are auctioning treasury bills. When the treasury bills are auctioned, will get more inflows for Reserve Bank of India. Why they are auctioning? Reserve Bank of India is the fundraiser for the government of India. They will raise the funds by auctioning treasury bill and they will deliver the funds to government of India. So the treasury bill normally tenure, 91 days, 182 days, 364. Here is the question, every paper, this treasury bill, definitely minimum 2-3 questions will be there. And less than 91 days also now Reserve Bank of India is issuing. That is known as cash management bill. So it's a SLR investment. If you invest in this, any bank invest in CMB, that is cash management bill, is a, so A is also SLR. B, balance with RBI in excess of CRR. That also qualifies for SLR. Please remember, CRR always, okay, CRR separate. Suppose you are keeping money in the current account with RBI, more than your 3%, that more than money you are keeping the RBI, no, that will also qualify for SLR because it's with RBI, the government. Okay, so reverse repo. What is reverse repo? If banks are keeping, getting a lot of money, instead of investing, giving loan or investing in other share market, the safe is invest with RBI. That is known as reverse repo, short term investment, maybe overnight or 15 days, 30 days. That is known as what? Reverse repo, you know, borrowing instrument. Reverse repo is an investing instrument. If my bank is having a lot of money, reverse repo. That also qualifies for what? SLR. So I have invested 1,000 crores with RBI, reverse repo. Some short-term funds I got, the Canara Bank or any State Bank of India or PNB. So that serves them as a SLR security. So C is SLR, treasury bill, 91 days SLR, 182 days SLR, 364, all treasury bills qualify as SLR security. Central government security, yes, SLR. State government securities, yes, SLR. State government, PSU bond, this is not a SLR. So I have listed A, B, C, D just as a wider option. But in the exam, 4-5 option, I think 5 option they are giving, they will twist you. So the correct answer is PSU bonds are not considered as SLR. What is PSU? Public sector unit, HAL, Bharat Earth Movers Limited, Whole India, Air India, is managed by Government of India. And the major shareholders are government. But when you invest in that bonds, that will not qualify as SLR. So the correct answer is G is not a SLR. Just a wider option. Please remember, one sure question will come, which is not a SLR security. Understood, friends? A to F SLR, only G is not a SLR security, it doesn't qualify. Agreed? So question number 6. Okay, so after this, okay, I will want to have an in-dream feedback. After this, okay, now I am going to the mathematical part. Okay, friends, one of you can
answer.
Going is good.
Very good, sir. Very good, sir.
Or increase the speed. Okay. You can immediately mute. Okay. Now you see the question. These are the question very frequently being asked. Your bank has got 20% in SP. 100 rupees you have got, 20% of funds come from SP. And SP 3.5% interest you are paying. Okay. It's a simple question, but you have to use your calculator. And 15% in CA. 100 rupees deposits you are getting money. 15% in CA. CA zero interest. Don't worry. The rest in term deposit. Rest in term deposit means 25 plus 15, 40. So 60% of the money comes in term deposit. Average cost 6.5. What is the weighted cost of the liabilities? Is the liability. Current account, savings bank account. Simple question. But what they are asking? Weighted cost. Weighted average cost. So how to calculate mathematically? You see. How to calculate? 25%. 25% you put as 25. But the 3.5 interest, okay, you have to convert your decimal. 3.5% divide by 100. When you divide by 100, how much you'll get? 25. Here, this percentage you ignore. 25 into 0.035. Why always interest you convert to decimal? Decimal means by 100. So 25 into 0.035, 0.875. Understood? This is the average cost of SP funds. Current account zero, you are not paying any interest. Okay. Now term deposit 40%. 40 or 60. So 25, 15, 40. The remaining 60 you put. Percentage, don't worry. Into 6.5, you are converting to decimal. 6.5 become 0.065. That become 3.9. Well, this point you have to ignore. 3.9. So the overall average cost is 3.9 for term deposit, 0.875 for SP, current account zero. So the overall cost of funds for this bank is a happy bank. Because 25% of the deposits are by SP and 15% no interest. And 60%, the cost is only 65. So the overall cost is 4.775. These are the questions they are asking. Understood or not? Simple, but don't miss it. This is a way of calculating weighted average cost. They will use the word weighted average cost. This is how you have to calculate. This may be, sometimes they are asking this type of question in credit management also. When they are, you are doing a project financing, these questions will be asked. Understood? Okay. Now, 8th question. This is a different question. Because they will twist. Now, that day, that question, we talked only about liabilities. Now they are talking about assets. A bank gets 6.4. SLR securities are assets. The bank gets 6.4 on SLR. How much they have invested in SLR? 18%. And loans and advances, 7.2. How much they have invested in 7.2? They have given a clue. Remember, CD ratio 65. What is CD ratio? How much loan they have given? They are not telling. What is CD ratio? Credit. Sorry, credit and deposit, CD ratio. Okay, this CD different. Credit deposit, CD ratio, 65%. What does it mean? For every 100 rupees deposits, current account, savings bank account, term deposit, 65 rupees is given as loans. It may be short-term loan, it may be bill discounted, it may be long-term loan, all 65. So that means on 65% of the assets, you are getting 7.2% return and CRR, you know, 3%, but zero income. Please remember, what you invest in Reserve Bank of India current account is a current account. They will not give any interest. So the 3% of funds, zero income. Okay, cash 2%. Cash they have got, that is cash mean physical cash. That also will not get any return. So cash 2%, zero return. Cash mean what? Cash in the branch level. This CRR means what? Cash with RBI. So these 2 plus 3, 5%, zero income for the bank. Please remember. That is why don't keep more cash in the branch. Okay. Now investment, SLR investment, SLR investment they have given 18, other investment 6.6. Now the question is, what is the average return on assets? Now how to, same way you have to do SLR income. SLR income how much? You assume maximum 18. Okay. Rate of interest how much? 6.4. Convert to decimal. 18 into 064, 1.152. If you have got a calculator, you afterwards you cross check. Okay. You know, because normally when you come for a regular program, we will make you to do. But if because it's a crash, okay, we'll explain. But afterwards, when you are free, you cross check. Cash held at branches, zero income. 2% goes, but zero income. Okay. CRR, 3%, zero income for the bank. Okay. So these 5% is a loss. Actually, it's a mandatory, statutory, no income. Loans. How much loan you have given? 65%. And how much income you are getting? 0.72. How we got 0.72? 7.2072. So 4.68%. Quickly you do it. Only matter of every question you have to spend only half minute. Because 100 question, 120 minutes. Some questions will be tough. So you have to, time management is very important. Next. Now other investment, how much you total all this? 18 over here 2, 18 plus 5 how much? 23 plus 65 how much? 88. Now how much is remaining? Only 12 is remaining. This is how I got 12. Please remember, this is how you have to work out. 18 over, 2 over, 18 plus 20, 23, 65 plus 23 means 88. So the remaining 12 rupees, they will invest in other securities, non-SLR security. And what is the income? 6.6. So 12 into 0.066, that is 0.792. Now you total all this, that is the average return. You see how beautiful the question they have framed. Sometimes they will twist you. Assets and liability, how much they should earn? They will ask that question also. Now, all of you understood? This is a simple question. Read the question carefully. One mark question. So one mark will make you richer. Richer day by day.
Okay.
Yeah, 6.64. How I got 6.64? You total all this. 1.14, 4.68, 0.792, you will get 6.64. This is the income. Please remember, this is the income from assets. Okay. And here, on loans, you have to pay your provisions and all. That is why every bank is now struggling for NIM. What is NIM? Net Interest Management. Net Interest. And NII, what is NII? Interest expenditure, interest income minus interest expenditure, net interest income. So NII is low mean because main source of income for the bank is interest income. That is why you are focusing on non-interest income, issuing guarantee, issuing LC, issuing derivative products, okay, making investments. All these are non-interest income, correct? Okay, now question number. Yes. Now, okay. Question comes. How MIBOR rates are determined? I think you have heard about LIBOR rates. LIBOR rate is determined by a group of banks. Earlier, Bank of England was doing. Now, it is being done by some leading banks in London. They will make a mean. That is mean average. And they will announce every day. And here in MIBOR, the rate will be announced by whether it is RBI, no. Whether it is ongoing call money market, no. MIBOR is Mumbai Interbank Offered Rate. Who is deciding? We have to see. This is a very often asked question. I believe it or not, every exam, MIBOR. These are the questions very often being asked. Based on inputs received from a panel of 30 bank and primary dealer. Who is the primary dealer? They are asking. The person authorized by, authorized dealer means Forex. The banks authorized to buy and sell dollar or foreign exchange known as authorized dealer. Similarly, primary dealer is a bank or a financial institution authorized to buy or issue or sell government securities. They are government securities. They are known as primary dealer. Please remember, what is primary dealer? Don't get confused. This is a definition of primary dealer. Okay. Based on ongoing LIBOR rates. LIBOR is for other currency. Okay. Understood. LIBOR is for other currency. The answer is 3. What is 3? Based on a panel of 30 banks. Okay, friends? Okay. So, out of the 4 options, they will try to test you. pick up the correct answer, 1 mark. Now question number 10. You see, this is again mathematical. A share is expected to be quoted at 1500 after 1 year. After 1 year, one share. What is the current value of the share? You have to now calculate. After 1 year, one analyst is telling Reliance share. One share may become 1500 next year, guarantee. Some people will bluff you, but you have to believe the forecast. At what rate you can buy today, the expected return is 15%. You want at least 15% return. And you see the next one, inflation rate is 10%. Now you have to adjust the inflation also. What is inflation? Inflation will pull down your value of money. Inflation will pull down, or it will, no, what you can buy, inflation is 10% mean, what you can buy today, 100 rupees worth goods, that will cost you 110 rupees next year. That's the meaning. So the inflation you have to adjust. Now how to calculate? So the expected return after 1 year is 1500. And 1500, first you have to adjust the inflation. The real value after 1500, it will become. So 1500, 10% first you adjust. 1500 minus 10%. Okay, just straight away minus. So it will become real value is 1350. On 1350, inflation adjusted value after 1 year. Now, how much you can bid, how much you can spend, or how much you can offer to buy the share today if your return is 1.5, and you have to remember the formula. I think all of you remember the formula. Present value, PV, I think, okay. Note down the formula. PV is equal to, okay, the formula whether I have, PV is equal to, remember the formula. Formula I have given. Formula used is PV. What is PV? Present value. What is PN? Future value. The value at the nth year will be more. The value at the today value will be less. Always remember, value as you, second year value, third year value, time value of money. I think you'll have I discuss this in business mathematics. So this is today's value, present value. This is future value. Divided by, you have to reduce, you have to discount. The future value discounted by 1 plus R. R always expressed in decimal. To the power N. N mean always years. Okay. Supposing compounded yearly. Yearly compounding mean no problem. Supposing compounded half yearly mean the rate of interest will be half. And the N will be doubled. I think this will have discussed in business mathematics. Supposing the interest is compounded quarterly, then the rate of interest per annum will be divided by 4 and the tenures will be multiplied by 4. But formula is here. Remember, I think this formula you have discussed in your business mathematics also. Now, what rate you can buy? 1350 divided by, how I got 1350? Or the market value, expected market value after 1 year, but you have to adjust the inflation also, because inflation will bring down the real value. So inflation you adjust 1350, and again you find out the present value, 1 plus R to the power N. N mean 1 year. So you can buy at 1000 at a price not exceeding 1174. Supposing they will twist the question. Supposing it is twisted at, it is quoted today at 1100. Whether you will buy? Yes, I will buy. Why? Because I can go up to a maximum. Maximum cut-off price 1174. Is a value I can give. The share I can buy based on this assumption. But today it is quoted at what rate? 1100. Now it is a discount. 74% profit for me. Suppose it is quoted at 1200 today. I will not buy. Why I will not buy? Because it is quoted at a price more than my real value. The real value is 1174, but today it is quoted at 1250 or 1300. Why I should buy at a higher cost? Okay, then that my return will come down. Instead of 15% return, you will get a lower return. Why I should lose my return? So if the price is less than this, I will buy. The price is more than this, I will not buy. Okay, they will twist the question. You have to understand, because you should get at least 15% return. Correct. The price is more, your return will come down. The price is still less, your return will still go up. So at a price not exceeding cut-off price, they will use the word cut-off price. Okay, friends, these are the terminology they will use. You have to familiarize. Agreed? So the answer can, at this rate, 1174. You will buy at a higher rate or lower rate, not exceeding 1174. It is lesser than this, happy, but more than 1174, unhappy. You have to take a decision because your yield rate will come down. Understood? These are the mathematical part, logical part, the prudence. Okay, so you have to think. 11th question. But a hybrid instrument, these are the twister, just to twist you, they will ask this question. Because some words, you know, fancy words, always they will use in the exam just to find out whether you are comfortable with the terminologies. Hybrid instrument mean, remember, not hybrid. Hybrid mean combination of debt and equity. Please remember, convertible bonds. What is convertible bonds? Is a bond is a debt instrument, is a loan. Bond is a debt instrument. Debt mean it is repayable. But convertible bond, what is convertible bond? It can be converted to equity. Equity, you need not have to pay back. Understood? So such instruments are known as hybrid instrument. If you are investing in convertible shares, convertible share also hybrid instrument. Why? Share is normally is a equity instrument. But convertible means what? That it can be converted to debt instrument. So that such instruments are known as what? Hybrid instrument. They will give question, which is not a hybrid instrument. Okay. Well, you remember always the concepts, combination of twin character instrument. What is twin? Now you see the question. Government bonds are not hybrid. Combination of debt and equity, that's a correct one. You see, single one word, if you understand, you'll get a one mark. The other day I told, going long, going short. Going long mean go on buying. Going short mean go on selling. This terminology will be used in trading deals or treasury operations, bonds, okay, combination of debt. So the answer is D. Agreed, friends? Okay, 12th one. What are the perpetual bond? Now perpetual bonds have become a fashion. What is perpetual bond? Perpetual bonds are coming under two categories. Perpetual bond means a debt instrument, bond. Cumulative perpetual bond, non-cumulative perpetual bond. Okay, please remember. Cumulative, non-cumulative. What is the difference between cumulative and non-cumulative? All perpetual bonds, remember, note down, all bonds, perpetual bonds, RBI is allowing only on non-cumulative basis. Non-cumulative. Cumulative means what? The interest will be added and at the end you have to pay a heavy amount. The principal amount. But in non-cumulative, at the end, you have to pay only the principal amount because interest you are paying now. Every now and then. Perpetual mean, again, they will twist you. Which sort of perpetual bond banks are permitted to invest in? Remember, non-cumulative perpetual bond. Why they are called perpetual bond? It will have no definite maturity period. So they will twist you. Whether it is high yielding investment? No. Have longer maturity? Longer mean how long? Long, long, long. Longer mean vague terminology. Have indefinite maturity. This is the correct word. Longer maturity, not correct, but indefinite maturity. Indefinite means normally it is not beyond 15 years. Okay. And it will have call option, put option. What is call option, put option? I think we'll have discussed. Okay. Anyhow, call option mean in note down. Call option mean in an investment, call option mean it's a right for the company that issues the bond to redeem the bonds before the due date. Note down. Call option mean call option bonds. Bonds with call option mean the company, the not investor. There are two things you have to remember. When a company is issuing a bond, or Government of India is issuing a bond, or State Bank of India is issuing a bond, that issuer of the bond is known as what? Borrower. And the person who invests is known as what? Investor. One second. Okay. The person who invests is known as investor. Call option means the rights are with the borrower. Okay, and the institution which issues the bond, they will have rights to redeem the bond before the due date. That is known as what? Call option. It may be indefinite maturity, but if they have got the funds, mean they will redeem the bonds. Sometimes, you know, the market will be coming. Rate of interest will be coming down. But I have accepted a bond at 10%. Why I should keep a bond at 10%? I will now raise the bond at lower interest and I will pay the bond at higher interest. I will redeem the bond. Okay, but 5-year lock-in is there. Please remember, before 5 years, what is put option? They will ask put option. Put option. What is the put option? Investor has the rights to demand premature. Sir, I have invested in a perpetual bond. Now I am seriously wanting money. At the end of 5 years or at the end of 6th year, the option is exercised by the investor. That is known as put option bonds. Okay, friends, callable bonds. There are different varieties are there, dated bonds. So perpetual bond mean the answer is indefinite maturity. Answer C, not redeemable anytime. That is anytime mean that is free bond, callable bonds. Callable bonds mean anytime they will redeem, that is redeemable anytime. Okay, but here perpetual bond mean it will have no fixed maturity date. They will not tell 20 year, 15 year. They will tell yes, bond, perpetual bond. How they are naming this, how they will not. Can you issue a deposit receipt without putting the due date of maturity? But these bonds are issued without any due date of maturity. You see the beauty. These are the new instrument. These perpetual bonds are qualifying. Non-cumulative perpetual bonds are qualifying as, note down, tier 1 capital. The additional tier 1 people have to mobilize now. So the perpetual bonds, non-cumulative perpetual bonds issued by the banks qualify for tier 1 capital for the bank. Is a Basel III you'll have discussed. Okay, now question, mathematical question.
What sir, is put the option? Can you explain once again, sir?
Put option mean I am okay. I am LIC. I am the managing director of LIC. I have invested 1,000 crores in Canara Bank or State Bank of India under perpetual bond. Okay, perpetual bond means what? Canara Bank may give me the money back. What time they will repay the money? I do not know. Normally, perpetual bond will have more rate of interest because you are taking the risk and investing for an indefinite period. When you will realize the investment, that is why, supposing I am LIC. LIC is keeping 1,000 crores with the State Bank of India as in perpetual bond. Okay. Now, there are two options. Call option, put option. What is call option? State Bank of India can exercise. They have issued a perpetual bond. After some 5 years, I am with so much money. I will give a notice, you get your money, I will redeem your bond. So I will discharge my liability. This is known as call option bonds. Agreed? What is put option bond? The LIC is investing. LIC has invested in SBI. LIC having lot of money and they are clearly telling, sir, give me put option. Put option means what? As an investor, though I have invested for indefinite period, after 5 years, I want emergency, LIC feels, I want the 1,000 crores back. Now they will exercise. You understood? Note down, put option will be exercised by investors. Call option will be exercised by the company which issues the bond. The borrowing company, the fundraising company will issue, yes, will exercise call option. Understood, boss? Now, perpetual bonds are not issued with put option, note down. Perpetual bonds will not be issued with which option? Put option will not be there. It will always be issued with call option. What is call option? Only bank can decide. Understood? Is one of the important questions that will help you to score 1 mark. Now, understood or not, boss? Okay. Now, 14. Now is a good question. These are the questions.
Sir, in both call option and put option, only after the lock-in period only they are demanded.
Yes, yes. Lock-in period is 5 years. Lock-in period only you can exercise. So the normal
after the lock-in period only.
Yes, yes. After the lock-in period, if the bank is exercising, that is known as call option. The investor wants to redeem before maturity. Okay, but all depositor, other deposit, you have the embedded option. Embedded option means at any time, though it may be 10-year deposit. You go tomorrow, you can ready, you can pre-close your deposit, yes or no? But this perpetual bond, you cannot pre-close, nothing you can do, yes. Okay, the call option also can be exercised only after 5 years. Understood, boss? Okay. Now, what is the effective rate? These are the questions they are asking. What is the effective rate in the cumulative bond? Face value 1,000, coupon rate 6.4, 3-year semi-annual compounding. Oh my God. 3-year semi-annual compounding is a 3-year bond. Okay, so the rate of interest will become semi-annual. Semi-annual mean you see the formula. Formula is same. That formula was discounting. This formula is for compounding. What is compounding? Future value. Future value is equal to present value. PO. PO mean here will not either you can use PV or PO. PO mean original investment. Principal amount original. Into it will not come divider. Now into money will grow up. Okay, future money is more than present money, understood? But when you have to come in the reverse direction, present money is always lower than future money. You understood the two concepts? Future money is always more value, that is numeric value only. Real value, don't worry, because inflation will interfere. The future value will be more than present value. In other words, the present value will be less than future value. Understood? These are two coins of a statement. Now future value is equal to, now he is investing. He is investing in a cumulative bond. Investor, from the point of view of the investor, I am 1,000 rupees I am investing today at 6.4 per annum. 6.4 mean per annum without telling. And 3 years semi-annual compounding. This is a formula. The formula you have to remember, simple formula. So semi-annual mean what you will do? 1000 into 1.032. Why 032? 6.4 divided by 2. Why you are dividing by 2? Semi-annual. And 3.2 you convert to decimal. 0.032 to the power 3 years means 6 times you have to the power of 6. This is to the power, not just 6, to the power. So take your calculator. How to do in the calculator? I think all of you will remember. 1.032 you key in. Okay, this is first half year. Into you put 1.032. If you want to practice, you all of you, first to 1.03 you key in. This is first half year. Into you put 1.032 again, and you put equal to. When you put equal to, something you will get 1.06 something you will get. Then you go on pressing equal to. This is the second half year. The third press you put, third half year equal to. You only put equal to. Fourth of year again equal to, fifth, sixth, carefully you put the equal to, the final equal to when you put, you'll get the value 1208. You can try. 1000 you are investing, 1208 you are getting because semi-annual compounding. Now the question is effective rate per annum. What you will do? Income 208, 1000 invested 208. The 208, how many years you have waited? 208 you have got for 1000 rupees, 208 by 3. Why you are dividing by 3? 3 years. Okay. So 208 by 3, you will get 69 point something. But this 69 is for 1000 rupees. Now, to convert to 100, 6.93. Though you have invested in 6.4, this is simple interest. Because of the cumulative effect, your overall return is 6.93. Here they will twist you. How much percentage more? 0.53 more. Understood, boss? 0.53 more. The question will be twisted in any pattern. This is known as what? Effective rate of return. I think this will have discussed in your business mathematics also, but it is also related to treasury. Even if it doesn't come under business mathematics, this type of questions are asked in treasury. Agreed? Understood or not? Okay. Again, you go through. What is the effective rate? One more question I am giving. What is the effective rate? My God, 6.4 per annum, 3 years, quarterly compounding. When you are compounding quarterly, the effective rate will still go up. Please remember. When it is monthly compounded, still overall impact will be more. And agreed. I think all of you, as a banker, you are familiar with the concept. Now, how to calculate? Same formula. Here I have 6.5, I have divided by 4. Why you have divided by 4 quarterly? So 6.4 when divided by 4, it become 1.6. So the 1.6 you convert to decimal, 1.016 to the power 12. Sir, why 12? 3 years into 4. So same way you do calculator, go on pressing equal to 11 equal to only you have to put. When first you are already keying 1.016, that will become 1. So into, so second equal to, third equal to, carefully you have to put. So the 11th equal to you will get for 12 rest. So how much you will get? 210 you will get. 1,210 you are getting. Why in the 1,210 principal amount is 1,000. So income alone 210 divided by 3, you will get 70 rupees. Correct? 70 rupees. Why I am convert 7 rupees? Because 1,000 rupees 70, 100 rupees 7%. So that though you are investing in 6.4, your overall return can increase to 7 because the effect of what? The effect of compounding. How much more? 0.6% more. They will test you how much more you will get in percentage. You read the option carefully. 0.6% more. Very good. Understood? Okay. Now question number 16. These are all the question very often being asked. So familiarize with this question. You are definitely you are clearing more than 22 marks you can get in treasury alone. I am guaranteeing you. If you are comfortable with all the questions we are discussing, don't have to worry. All questions I am sharing with you. What rate? Because I am not giving so many questions on the same question, only one sample. What rate one can buy a bond? Now testing. What rate you can buy a bond? The face value 1,000. Face value means what? Zero coupon bond. I think zero coupon bond is a super concept. ZCB, zero coupon bond. Sometimes they will use the word abbreviation also. But is ZCB, don't get confused. Okay, that is zero coupon bond. What is zero coupon bond? You are investing an amount today, a reduced amount today, all treasury bill, all CDs, all commercial paper, all are what? Zero coupon bonds. Zero coupon means what? Bond means more than 1 year. But these are all short-term instruments. What is zero coupon? You will invest an amount today. You will not get any interest income in between. The investor will not get any interest cash flow from the date of investment till the date of maturity. He will get the full interest only on the due date. This is also known as what? Cumulative deposits. Cumulative bonds. And bond, you don't use the word for bond. When you use the word, it is more than 1 year only. You have to use the word bond. But when the instrument is less than 1 year, don't use the word bond, because commercial paper less than 1 year, treasury instrument, treasury bills less than 1 year, CD less than 1 year, CP, CD, and the call money market less than 1 year. So here rate of return will be calculated in a different formula. So now the question is a 3 year annual compounding. Oh my God, 3 year annual compounding. The coupon rate, coupon mean rate of interest. Coupon, this is the word they will use in bond. Bond is 1,000. Now we have to come in the reverse. 1,000 PV, present value is equal to future value compounded annually. Annual mean, don't worry, 1,000 divided by 1.064 and to the power 3. Why annual compounding mean? Don't have to reduce. Don't have to divide by 2. Semi-annual mean divide by 2, but multiply by duration. So 1,000 divided by 1.064 to the power 3, 830. 830 is the current value of the bond. If it is quoted at 830, you buy today. You are getting 6.4. Suppose the quoted at 800, will you buy or not? You will buy. Why? I will give another question. So today the real value is 830. Supposing today the bond has its market, you know, somebody who is in a hurry, they will go on selling. A car real value may be 5 lakh, but somebody wanting money, they will do distressed sales. They will, anyhow lesser. So more people are selling, the price will come down. Please remember. So though the value of the bond is 830, supposing the bond somebody is selling at 800, will you buy or not? Yes, you will buy. Why? Because your rate of return will be more than. Now at this rate, you are getting only 6.4. When you buy at 800, it will become more than 6.4. It will be, your return will be more than coupon rate. Suppose you are buying at 900. Today, it is sold at 900. Will you buy the bond? No, you will not buy the bond. Why? You will not buy the bond because it is quoted at premium. Now it is quoted at 800 mean discount. Please remember. 900 mean premium. These are the terminology you have to, your video, your mind should run a video when you are in the exam hall. Sir, video I have to run? No. Your mind should be on the question. Okay. So the real value 830 mean you will get 6.4. When you buy at a lower rate, your yield rate will improve. Yield rate is different. Coupon rate is different. Coupon rate is the rate assured by the issuing company at the time of issue. But yield rate is the rate which you get as an investor in an instrument depending on the market price. Depending on the market. Because the market price will go on changing. Supply and demand. More people are selling, the price will crash. More people want to buy, price will go up, supply and demand. Okay. So 8:30, here the future value will be discounted to get the present value. Understood? So the question they will twist you. Now the question is, now they are asking, a bond is 1,000 rupees face value. What does it mean? What does it mean? 1 year bond. It's a 1 year bond. After 1 year, you will get 1,000 rupees. And if you invest today and the coupon rate means what? The rate assured by the company inbuilt interest rate is 6.4. But that 6.4 coupon rate. But depending on the market value, your yield rate will be different. 1 year, but quoted at 9:30. Whether it is a premium or discount? This is the question they are asking. How much premium? How much discount? What will be the yield rate? Will be more than the coupon rate or less than the coupon rate? You understood now? Okay. Now to answer the question, first you have to find out the present value. How to find out the present value? 1,000 divided by 1 year. 1.064. 1.064. Take your calculator. You will get 939. So what does it mean? The real value today is, based on the coupon rate, 939.85. But at what rate it is quoted? 9:30 it is quoted. So it's a good thing for the investor? Yes, it's a good thing. Because prices are lower than the real value. Market value is lower. How much lower? 9.85 rupees lower. Whether it is good or no, it is discount now. Okay. Suppose it's quoted at 950, it is premium. Understood? Premium discount mean? Premium mean at a price higher than the market price, that's the real price. And discount mean when the real price, the market price is lower than the real affordable price or the calculated price, then that is known as what? Discount premium. Agreed? Understood? Okay, this concept, definitely 2-3 questions they will test you. You are confident man, and you are very confident. All question you can crack CIB, I am assuring you. So many people are getting 79-80% when they are grip over the concepts. So the question is, market price is 9:30, so it is a discount. Then what will the impact of the discount? Yield rate will improve. Because you are buying low, you know. Now your income will be 70 rupees, please remember. Your income will be 70 rupees. You are investing 9:30 today, you take your calculator. At this rate, what is the yield rate they will ask? Supposing the question they twisted, okay, now it is at a discount. Now, what is the yield rate at this rate, at this stage? Well, what is the yield rate? You are investing 9:30 today. How much you will get? 1,000 rupees you will get at the end of 1 year. So, how much income you are getting? 70 rupees. So, 70 you put at the top, divided by 9:30. You press your percentage button. What 9:30? Today you are investing 9:30 only, no? You put your percentage button, you will get 7.52. The coupon rate is 6.4, but your yield rate is today 7.52. 7.53 also you can take. This is how they will test you. So when the bond is at a discount, yield rate will be more than the coupon rate. Note down. This concept you have not understood. Supposing bond is quoted at a higher price, the real value is 939. If it is quoted at 960, then yield rate will below, the yield rate will be lower than the coupon rate. Understood or not? These concepts you have to understand. When premium mean, yield rate will be lower. At discount mean, yield rate will be higher than the coupon rate. This concept you understood. 2 marks you are scoring. Please remember, 2 marks you are assured. You tell me afterwards. Okay. 18th, the bond face value 1,000, coupon rate 6.4, one year bond, it today quoted at 950. Just now I told you, no, what is the yield rate? Oh my God, it is more than the real value. First you find out the real value. Now you don't have to calculate real value. What is the yield rate only they are asking? Simply, you are 1 year. If it is 3 year mean, you have to calculate in a different pattern. Now, you are investing 950 today. Today, after 1 year, you are going to get 1,000 rupees. Now, your income will be 50 rupees. Your interest income will be 50 rupees. The difference between what you get afterwards, what you invest today, divided by 950. You are investing 950 and you multiply by your 100. So, 50 divided by 950, percentage button you press 5.26. Sir, why 5.26? Coupon rate is 6.4. Coupon rate is different. Yield rate is different. Now, why yield rate is less? Because the price is more than the real price. Real price will be something less. Just now we discussed 930 something. But it's quoted at 950. The real return, yield rate, that is known as yield rate. OETM is different. Yield to maturity is different. Yield rate. So many questions. Minimum 2-3 questions. Because everybody is concerned with yield rate. Now the yield rate is lower than the coupon rate. Now at this rate, nobody, you should not buy. You should not buy this bond because it is quoted at a high rate. Your yield rate will come down. So it is not wise to buy this, invest in this bond today because yield rate is down. Yield rate is lower than the coupon rate. Agreed or not? This is how analytical thinking. Analytical thinking will help you. This you have to go. Should not go on thinking in the exam hall. Quick thinking. Pick up the correct answer. You are scoring. Your score rate will, the answer I have given. Okay. Now 19th. There are three desks. Every question they are asking. Even last exam, this question was asked. Normally, treasury is a centralized function. It's a specialized activity. Normally, at the corporate office, there are three desks. I think all of you remember. Front desk. What is the role of the front desk? They will click the deals. How much to be invested? How much to be redeemed today? Okay. Or any investment maturing today? And that backup session different. Investment and borrowing. Clicking the deal is done by whom? Yes, treasury, the front desk. Okay, now second desk is known as mid desk, mid office. Either they will call mid office or mid desk. They are managing the risk. Oh, these are the risk parameter. Market is coming down and the rate of interest is falling down. So the rate of interest falling down means what? The bond price will go up. Again, you remember, these are the questions they are asking in the interview also. When the rate of interest is coming down, what will happen to the price of the bond? Always remember, both are opposite. Note down right now. When the rate of interest comes down, market rate of interest comes down, bond price will go up. Why? You tell me why. Because rate of interest, both are opposite. Rate of interest coming down, bond price will go up. When the rate of interest goes up, bond price will come down. Okay, both are opposite. Interest rate up mean price will come down. Interest rate lower mean price will move up. Both are opposite. Why? Because you are dividing. Okay. So this concept you have to understand. Any bond, the rate of interest going up, rate of interest going up, bond price will come down. Any bond, normally, the rate of interest is high, price, market price will come down. Both are opposites. Okay. So there are three desks, front desk, mid desk. Mid desk is mainly concerned risk management. And they are concerned with the procedural guideline, how to click the deal, what is the guideline from corporate office, guidelines from Reserve Bank of India. The third office is known as settlement, follow-up and settlement. A simple question they will ask, mid-office, back-office, I think all of you are familiar, delivery of funds and collecting funds, settling interest, everything will be done by back-office, okay? Front office, back-office, okay. Now, question number. Numeric question. A bond face value 1000, coupon rate 6.4, 1 year tenor is today quoted at 930. What rate one can buy if the expected yield rate is 7%? Now they are going to twist you. Today quoted at 930, simply ignore. And 6.4 also, you don't worry. You have to ignore. You see how they are twisting. What rate one can buy if the expected yield rate is 7? You want at least 7. As an investor, you want at least 7. They will twist you. I want at least 7% return. Okay? Because if I invest in a bank, they are giving 6%, 5.6 only they are giving. I want minimum 7. So, I want this investment in a bond, 1 year bond. So, what I will do? 6.4, 930, ignore. Just to confuse you. Simply take 1000 divided by 1.07. Why 07? Present value is equal to future value divided by 1 plus r to the power n. So here future value is 1000. Present value 1 plus r. 1 plus 1.07 to the power 1, don't worry. So the real price you can buy is 934.58. Less than 934, any price not more than 934.58. Any price less than 934.58, I will buy. But it is quoted at 930. Will you buy? Yes, this is the cutoff rate. I should buy at the rate not exceeding 934. But it is less than 934. 930 is quoted. I will be happy because the yield rate will be still more than 7%. You calculate, it will become 7.52. Agreed? That question they will test you. At what rate you can invest? At a rate not exceeding, not lower than 934. They will give you two options. So you have to pick up the correct option at a price, market rate, not exceeding 934.58. That means anything lower than that is a welcome. It will give you more return, more profits. Agreed? Okay, this is a question they will test you. When the interest rate, this also I have given you, keep it in mind. When the interest rate goes up, bond price is coming down. When the interest rate goes down, bond price will move up. Both are opposite. Based on this concept, this is a fundamental theory. Based on this theory, one or two questions will be there in the treasury management. Okay, don't miss the question. Now 21, money market instrument. The question will be, which is not a money market instrument? They will give a variety of instrument and you have to pick up. Money market means note down, short term instrument. You are investing or borrowing, some company is borrowing, there are two people in the market. Okay, the third party is trader. Who are the primary two parties? Investor and the borrower. One fellow having money is investing. Another man, another institution, another bank or a company wanting money, they are borrowing. Borrowing by issuing a bond. Bond is a commitment. Okay, so you mean to say bank is also borrowing, bank is deposit. You call it decently, call it a deposit. But it's nothing but borrowing. We are borrowing from whom? We are borrowing from the public. Our savings bank is a borrowing. Our current account is a borrowing. Literally speaking, it's a borrowing. Our term deposit is a borrowing. But we dignify term, we call it deposit. It will appear as if we are borrowing. You understood? So we are really, if you analyze the real picture, the fixed deposit is nothing but a borrowing by the banks from the public. Remember. Okay. So which is not a money market instrument? Money market means 1 day to 1 year. Minimum maturity 1 year, overnight. Overnight also same. 1 day, overnight, both are same. Up to 14 days, call money. 28 days. Okay. That is known as what? Notice money, 30 days. More than 30 days, less than 1 year. That is known as term money. So the call money market also, there are three categories. I think all of you are familiar with that. Now call money, which is not a money market instrument I am giving, but the question will be, they will test you. What is call money? Call money is administered by group of banks. Just supply and demand. Call money means even RRBs now can participate. Overnight requirement. Instead of going to RBI, I will go to, yes. But what is the advantage of call money borrowing? And repo borrowing, you have to pledge your security. But call money borrowing, unsecured, please remember. Call money borrowing, there is a limit, unsecured. You need not have to give any securities, they will give. State Bank of India will give you 100 crore to your cooperative bank. Okay, to manage your overnight. You have to maintain SLR, no? SLR, you are borrowing money, call money, yes. Call money, three category. Repo, reverse repo. It's a money market instrument. Repo, borrowing, reverse repo, investing, short-term investment. Commercial paper. What is commercial paper? 7 days to 1 year they can issue. The rated corporates, not all corporates, all company cannot issue commercial paper. Only first class rated corporate. Then again they will ask a question, who will rate them? These are the questions they are asking. Whether anybody can rate them? RBI approved. Only 5 people are RBI approved. I think all of you know, CRISIL, ICRA, okay, CARE, and Fitch India, and BRICWorks. These are the 5 people approved by Reserve Bank of India to rate debt instruments and equity instrument. So these people will rate. So commercial paper means rated corporate only can issue commercial paper. Certificate deposit, normally banks. What is commercial paper to a company? Certificate deposit to a bank. We are borrowing. But what is the difference between our normal traditional deposit, time deposit and certificate deposit? These certificate deposits are tradable freely. Secondary market is there. That time deposits are non-transferable. Treasury bill. Treasury bill is a source of raising money for the government of India by Reserve Bank of India. And banks are safe. A bank will assured return, safe SLR security. So I will invest my surplus in treasury. Some banks are investing beyond 18% also. You get safe, you know, unnecessarily instead of giving loan. But you cannot just like that dump in only SLR security. There is a prudential limit is also there. Okay, minimum 18 you have to invest. More than 18 also you can invest, because if you want a loan, you can pledge that loan more than, that is known as unencumbered SLR. Encumbered SLR, 18% encumbered. This is a pledge to RBI. This is a must. More than 18 you have invested, that can be, yes, converted, that can be monetized. I think now Nirmala Sitharaman has found a new word, monetization of assets. That means your assets you are converting and you are getting cash flows out of your assets. That is known as monetization. Okay. So the treasury bills are sources of fundraising by government of India. From the treasury bills, normally banks will invest. And others also, big investors, institutional. CBLO means collateralized bank lending obligation. It is administered by CCIL, Clearing Corporation of India Limited. It is not administered by Reserve Bank of India. Reserve Bank of India administered repo. But repo, you should have a security, no? But in CBLO market, other securities, approved securities also, they will accept. And they will give mandatory rate, not any rate. There is a rate of, and you can bid also. So CBLO market, the CBLO is a collateral bank lending. It is over and above call money. But you have to participate in the bid. Call money is different, all NDS. NDS means negotiated dealing system. NDS means all screen based. Anybody wanting money, they will go to the Andhra Bank having money, Corporation Bank. Now, no, Corporation Bank, Andhra Bank, and now merged with Union Bank. They have got crores of money, they will go to the screen, they will quote, I have got 1,000 crores surplus, I want. So, like that, screen based trading is known as NDS, negotiated dealing system. CBLO, I think we'll discuss collateralized bank lending operation. All are short term instrument, money market instrument. Understood? The question they will twist you, which is not a money market? Simple. But they have to pick up. OMO, very often asked question. What is OMO? Because the banks are a little funny. Open money, open market operation. M stands for what? Market year. Sometimes M means money. Open market operation. Who will do this open market operation? Only Reserve Bank of India can do. Why they are doing? To reduce liquidity. How they will reduce liquidity? Liquidity is there with the banks. Banks are having a lot of money. How they will reduce the liquidity? By auctioning treasury bill, selling government bond, government of India bonds. So the liquidity will be reduced. How to enhance liquidity? They will redeem the bonds. Suppose a bank has invested with RBI. Okay, I will buy back. You get the money. So reduce liquidity. So the answer is either A or B, no. Only for B, no. Both only for A. So it is actually known as either ARB. C is the correct answer. So open market operation means Reserve Bank of India will do either to increase the liquidity or to reduce the liquidity. What is increase the liquidity? Banks are not having money, tight money. So bank will increase. What is decrease the liquidity? Banks are having flush, so much money. Reserve Bank of India will absorb that money. That is, both are dangerous, I told you, Over liquidity is also dangerous, under liquidity also dangerous. So the 23 is security are borrowing call money market. They will try to twist you. No security is needed. It's unsecured borrowing. Call money market is a overnight, mostly overnight. Okay. Overnight means what? To maintain your SLR CRR, you go to the screen, you get a rate. But these rates are not fixed by anyone, not linked to any MIBOR. It's a market-based return, market-based. That is supply and demand. Okay, sometimes call money market will be more than your repo rate, reverse repo rate, more rate of interest rate to pay, because market is very tight. Only State Bank of India is having some money. Other banks don't have money. Correct, you know? So they have to interbank adjustment. Interbank borrowings are known as what? Call money. Interbank borrowing or investments are known as call money. Okay, these are unsecured, no security. But you should be a member of the PDO. PDO means Reserve Bank of India should recognize as a call money player. Okay, you have to that mandatory SLR, CRR, whoever is filing, they can participate in call money market. Some people are borrowers, some people are investors. Okay, so many questions will come. One question definitely will come on call money market. Okay, friends. Yes, rate of interest for call money market decided by whom? Not decided by SEBI, not decided by RBI, not decided by participating bank. It is not MIBOR linked. It decided by market. Market forces. What is market forces? Note down supply and demand. What is supply? When money is so much available, demand is less, price will come down. Rate of interest will come down. I have got money, nobody to borrow. I have to reduce my rate. But I don't have money, but people are demanding money. Supply is less, demand is more. Interest rate will shoot up. Agreed? Simple theorem, application of mind, quickly you can answer. Participate in call money market. Who are not a participant, they will ask. They will test you. Indirect question, they will ask. They will not ask directly who are the participant. No. Who is not a participant in the call money market? They will give a list. Out of that, you have to pick up the person. Okay, odd man out. Okay, and these are the questions they will ask. All banks, including Cooperative Bank and RRB, yes, they are participant. NBFC, FIIs, they are participant. Participant does what? Participant does what? They cannot borrow, they can invest. They have got a surplus, you know, NBFC, FII. They cannot borrow, but they can give money. That is, there are two things in a call money market. Somebody wants money, I think you understand. Primary dealer. Primary dealer is nothing but an approved bank. Yes, C is also participant. D, only A and C. Yes, A and C. A and C participants mean normally these people are not really permitted because it's a call money market mainly meant for banks, but the FI is they're not permitted. But the insurance company, some people, you know, they are permitted to give money because sometimes the call money will be tight, you know. So the correct answer is out of the four options, only A and C, excluding land development banks. Land development bank, because a long-term loan bank, they are not eligible to participate in call money market because a term lending institution, no, LD bank, land development bank, A and C. Okay, so this is the answer. Primary dealers are bankers only, so they will try. Even now RRB also permitted. Earlier RRBs were not permitted to participate in call money. Now they are permitted, I think from September 2000 onwards. So the correct answer is D. Like that, sometimes descriptive answer, read the question carefully. Now 26, LAF, very often asked question. Liquidity adjustment facility. This is RB administered. Liquidity adjustment is open market also, other than RB also there. Okay, CCIL is administering call money. That is not coming under RBI purview. RBI is doing only liquidity mean repo, reverse repo. Repo, reverse repo. OMO is not, this is literally LAF mean liquidity adjustment facility offered by Reserve Bank of India. What is liquidity adjustment? When banks are with surplus money, you go under reverse repo. What is repo? When banks want money for a short time, they pledge their security, SLR security, and they get repo mean repurchase offer. It's a reverse. After a particular time, the securities will be exchanged, like a gold loan. Gold loan you raise, giving gold. When you get money, go to that man, sir, I have got money, give me gold back. So you are entering into an agreement, I will pay your loan with the interest, give me gold. Similar way, Reserve Bank of India will release your securities once you pay back your money. Okay. So the correct answer is B only. Repo and reverse repo are known as what? LAF facility, liquidity adjustment. Securities for RBI repo will be, suppose RBI is giving from RBI want loan. Why RBI loan is preferred by the banker? Rate are now LTRO is there. Long term repo is also there. And the long term repo is also there. Now short term repo, earlier not exceeding 1 year. Now long term repo, up to 3 year also banks are permitted to raise short term. This repo borrowing from, what is the advantage? It will be at a mandated rate. Repo rate is administered rate. We have to pay more interest. It is given by Reserve Bank of India, correct, you know? So no security is not the correct answer. Listed share, no. Shares will not be accepted by RBI because you are borrowing from RBI, please remember. unencumbered SLR security, yes. SLR security up to 18, you cannot pledge because it's mandatory. Over and above 18, that is known as unencumbered or free SLR, also known as what? Free SLR. Okay, unencumbered is the right word. That SLR you can pledge and you can raise short-term loan repo at the repo rate. Corporate bond and they will not accept. So answer is C. Very often asked question, Prime. Okay, simple question, but now arithmetic. Now what shall be the issue price of a commercial paper? Issue price. Always commercial paper will be issued at a discount to fetch the market value on the due date. These are the question. Believe it or not, these questions are asked. Just even if you are practicing, within 30 seconds also, you don't have to spend 1 minute, sometimes 30 minutes. You see, what shall be the issue price of a commercial paper? Face value 5 lakh, coupon rate 6.64, 1 year tenure. Simple. Take your calculator, 5 lakh divided by, 5 lakh divided by 1.0664. Because 1 year, no? Simply 1 year mean, this one 6.64 per annum. So 1.064. So the answer is, 4,68,867 is the price, issue price. Okay. If it is offered at a price lower than this, discount is still more. Your rate will be more than 6.64. Suppose you pay 4,70,000, your coupon rate will be 6.64. But when you are buying at a higher price, because the moment it issued, the original issue can immediately trade. So depending on the market, commercial paper, is a secondary market is there, so immediately they will, because the market will move. Okay, so the CP issued at a discounted price to get FE on the due date, this is zero coupon cash flows. So okay, now you have to issue that what? All commercial paper, all certificate of deposit, all treasury bills, all are zero coupon in nature. What is zero coupon? In between they will not give any interest to the investor. At the end, you get the interest. You invest low, lesser amount, reduced amount, that is discounted value you invest today, you'll get a big amount tomorrow. The difference becomes your income. I will not pay every now and then. That is known as zero coupon, zero cash flows. Understood? Now, treasury bill 91 days. Here, twisted. That 1 year mean you use that formula, but here 91 days sold at 98.21. What is the yield rate? It's a beautiful question. Note down this type of question. Yes, if you are thorough, another 2 marks you are scoring. Okay, this type of question. Very only one word you see. Treasury bill 91 days. Sold at 98.21. What is the yield rate? First, you have to find out the rate for 91 days. How will you find out the rate for 91 days? You are investing 98.21. They will not tell face value. Here, without telling, face value is 100. Please remember, 98.21, sir, they have not indicated the face value. No. Once they are told 98.21 mean, without telling, face value is 100. So, how much income you are getting? 900 you are getting after 91 days. Today, you are investing 98.21. So, how much income you are getting? 1.79 for 98.21. You are investing 98.21, 1.79. So, you convert your percentage. So, 1.79 divided by 98.21. Put your percentage button, you will get 1.8226. The 1.8226 for 91 days only, but yield rate always will be expressed per annum, convert to 365 days. Here, up to 1 year, Indian market, all money market, 365 days, remember. But in forex market, 360 days. That's the only difference. 365 days count. Okay, over 1 year, within 1 year only, the question arises. Sir, whether we will go by 365 or 360. In rupee market, Indian market, we are conventionally 365. So 365, how much you have to know? 91 days, 1.82. Or 365, how much? So 182 divided by 91 multiplied by 360. 91 days, this much means 365 is how much? Simple calculator. So you will get 7.31. Pick up the answer. 1 mark boss, believe it or not. 1 mark question. These are the question. The same question will be twisted. Treasury bill 182 days sold at some rate, 95.03 rupees. This is the same pattern you have to work. 30 seconds you are working. Sir, you are getting 1 mark. Yes, sir.
Sir, that point A first point 1.79, how it is got, can you please explain?
This is the income you are getting. You are investing 98 rupees 21 rupees today. Agreed? Today you are investing treasury bill 98 21. How much you are going to get after 91 day? 100 rupees. So this is the difference between what you invest, what you are getting. So the 1.79 is the interest income, boss. Understood now? The difference between what you invest is a zero coupon, no? You are investing 98.21 today, you are getting 100 after 1 year, after not 1 year, after 91 days. So your return, your income will be 1.79. That you convert to a percentage. 1.79 you are getting for 98.21. Don't use the 100. 100 is the face value. Today you are investing 98.21, 1.79 income. So it become 1.8226. The 1.8226 for income for 91 days. But yield rate mean always you have to express in per annum, convert to per annum. And you have to follow 365 days pattern. You calculate, you'll get 7.3. Understood, boss? Boss, one mark. One mark will, yes, take you to glory. Agreed? Cracking. Okay. Question number 30. Now I have told you, 100 and treasury bill 180 days. Very often asked question. 7.2 per annum issued. What should be the issue price? Now they are giving the coupon rate and they are wanting issue price. Now ulta. Earlier, you see the difference. Earlier, the issue price they gave and what is the income? What is the rate of return? Now, coupon rate 7.2, if it is, what should be the issue price? Okay. Now, issue price, you see, first to find out the coupon rate for 90. How many days? Oh, sorry. Question. Okay. Some mistake. It is 91 days. Okay. Treasury bill for 91 days. Okay. Anyhow, you take it for 91 days. Don't worry. 182 days. So, the answer is 182 days mean, okay. Now, but we'll assume it's instead of 182 days, 91 days. So, the coupon rate for 91 days, you have to find out. Coupon rate for 91 days, first you have to find out. How to find out? 70.2 is for how many? 7.2 per annum. 7.2 divided by 365. Why you are dividing by 365 per day? And you are multi. Oh, correct. Here this word only is missing. 182 days. So, the correct. 182 days. One day, how much you are getting? 7.2 for 365 days divided by 360. For 182 days, 3.590 is the rate of interest. When the rate is divided by 2, 7.2 divided by 2, but don't divide by 2. Quick way mean you can divide by 2. Shortcut I am telling. But real way is 7.2 divided by 365 multiplied by 182. Okay, 3.590. Now, what should be the price? What should be the price? 100 rupees will be the face value divided by 1.03590. What is your 1 plus R? The 3.590 convert to decimal. 0.0. 100 you divide. 1.03590. So what will be the issue price? 96.53. 96.53 invest today. After 182 days, you will get 100 rupees from the Reserve Bank of India. This will not be 100 rupees, nobody. It's a lot. One unit of treasury bill, 100 rupees, you will get at the end of 180 days. Today, you have to invest 96.53. Understood, boss? You can go through that worked out example. Definitely, you are cracking treasury because it will build up your confidence level. Step by step, I have explained. Now, you may not, but after reaching home, again, you practice. Any doubt, please, 31. Now, some derivative product also, sometimes there will be question. Product used to manage exchange rate risk. There are three risks you have to manage. Price risk you have to manage, interest rate risk you have to manage, and exchange rate risk you have to manage. Why you have to manage? Because it is goes on floating. Daily it is changing. So whether you will use forward contract, yes. Currency option, yes. Currency future, yes. All are instrument, derivative product to manage exchange rate risk. So derivative, there will be one question. Maybe sometimes one or two question. This will come in Forex also, treasury also. Why it is asked in treasury? Because these products are sold by your treasury room. individual branch will not sell these product, forward contract, currency option, currency future, all will help the customer or help the bank to manage any of the above. Any of the above question will not be asked, but know the concept. The answer is D. Forward contract also will manage exchange rate risk, currency option, currency future. Currency value is coming now. Forward contracts will manage only exchange rate risk, but FRA will manage interest rate risk, forward rate agreement. Okay, all possible questions I have given. 32 product used to manage interest rate risk. I told you two risks you have to manage carefully. Interest rate risk, because keeps on changing. LIBOR is different, MIBOR is different. Every day interest rates are only RBI rates will not change until 2 months, till the monetary policy is changed or announced, then it will be constant. Otherwise, other rates are daily changing. Okay, product used to manage interest rate risk in the short term borrowing in the foreign currency, they will give option. Okay, it's a technical question. Forward contract, no. Forward contract is not for interest rate. Interest rate option, yes. Swap, okay. Interest rate swaps are there. That also you can use. Forward rate agreement, yes. Interest rate risk in short term borrowing. Here also remember, not long term borrowing. The swaps are meant for long term. Interest rate option also long term. Forward rate is for exchange rate. So A, B, C not correct answer. So the only correct answer is D. Because forward rate agreement is meant for borrowing or investments up to a tenor. Tenor means tenure, maturity, not exceeding 1 year. Forward rate agreement. One question will be there. Remember. So the answer is D. Okay, friend. Short term instrument. Call option. I think all of you remember. Call option. In option contract, there are two people. Option contract itself, there are two people. Who are the two people? Buyer and the seller. Don't get confused. Buyer, what is buying? Buyer of rights. Seller, what seller is doing? Seller of rights. The option contract, technically you have to understand the basic concepts. Okay, I can explain the concept, but today want of time you are going straight. Call option mean rights to buy, note down. If you have got a pen, you note down. Call option mean rights to buy. Buy what? Any security. It may be forex, it may be shares, it may be bonds. Call option means rights to buy, and put option means rights to sell. Okay, I think I told you there are two parties in the option deal, buyer and seller. Seller always, note down, seller always a bank or stock exchange. Seller always, customer will not sell. The customer, corporate customers or institutions, they will only buy. Okay, options are sold only at the counters of, note down, the options are sold only at the futures are sold only at the counters of stock exchange. But options are sold only at the counters of a bank or stock exchange. And what is call option? Rights to buy a security. What is put option? Now question is, they will test you. Call option give rights to a, always the rights are given to another thing, you note down. Under option contract, rights are not given to a seller. Always rights are given to a buyer of the contract. The buyer of the contract may be an importer, may be an exporter, may be a borrower, or may be an investor. Is a contract. Who is the seller of the contract? I told some other party. It's a beautiful derivative product. So the answer is seller to sell, no. Buyer to buy. Call option B is the correct answer. But anyway, we read the all options. Option mean choices. Your option mean don't, sir. Option don't. All choices they will give. A, B, C, D. Exporter to buy. No, that is not call option. Exporter always will buy put option. Customers are always buying. So C is not correct. Importer to sell. Importer always will not sell. Importer always will buy. So importer will only buy call option. So D is not correct. C, elimination. So you have to pick up only B. B is the correct answer. Okay, friends. Option, the words they will try to play. One question will be, definitely they are on option contract. Because these words, you know, European option, for example, American option, European option, in the money, out the money, at the money. These are slightly, but when you understand in simple term, you see American option, note down. American option mean the rights can be exercised by the buyer, not seller. There always the rights will be exercised only by the buyer. In an option contract, buyer only is going to exercise the rights. American option mean the rights either to sell or buy can be exercised before the due date, any day before the due date is American option. European option mean the rights can be exercised only on the expiry date, only on the due date. Understood? So the American option normally seller to buy on any day. No, seller you don't worry. Option contract give rights to buyer. Buyer to exercise rights on any day. So C is the correct. But you wait. Go through all the choices. Exporter to buy forex on any day. No. Exporter will not buy. He will only sell. Importer will not sell. Importer will buy. Buy dollar. Agreed. So the American option, the answer is 34. C. Buyer to exercise rights on any day. European option means only on the expiry date. Okay. One question will be there. Why this is coming in treasury? Because the treasury product, these including derivatives, are money makers, that income earners for your bank. Please remember, your non-interest income is the main source of income. So many banks are earning profit, not because of giving loan, only because of treasury business, they are showing profit. Believe it or not, that's the reality. Okay, 35. Which is true in respect of NDS? This is the question they will twist you. Which is not applicable? Which doesn't arise? Which is not true? Which is true? Now question is, which is true? Which is not true, different. Which is true in NDS? NDS means negotiated dealing system. NDS is only for secondary market deals. Okay, we'll see. Okay, NDS is only for secondary market deal. Oh no, banks and primary dealers are only members of NDS. No, NDS is managed by SEBI. No, SEBI is not managed. SEBI is not managing. NDS is for trading in government securities and other money market deals. Oh, D appears to be correct. Okay, NDS is for trading in. Okay, so the question number one is also they have tested is, it's not only for secondary market, they have told. Sometimes even a primary market also NDS will be used. So the NDS is the trading platform, screen, transparent for Government of India securities and other money market instruments like CP, CD, buying, selling, all will be through NDS. So the correct answer is D. You see the choices carefully, understand the concepts, then you will not be twisted. What's the green shoe option? Why they are asking this? In an interview also they will ask. Because these are the some fancy words that always they will test you. Red herring prospectus. That's a actually capital market instrument. What is a green shoe option? Sometimes they are asking. Okay, because to just to test you. Supposing bank wants to invest in a share market, in a, the equity instrument, what is green shoe option? Over and above the IPO size. What is IPO? Initial public offer. Suppose the initial public offer is 5,000, they will give a simple example also. Green shoe option means the company which is raising the capital, they can issue 15% more shares under green shoe option. How much more? 15. The company is permitted to, it's a, in case of oversubscription in an IPO, because these are all connected to treasury, the issuing company can use the green shoe option up to 15% over and above the IPO size. They will give example. 5,000 is the IPO permitted by SEBI. IPO size will be permitted by SEBI, not by Reserve Bank of India. IPO, how much IPO you can raise, SEBI will permit. And they can go up to 5,000 plus another 15%. Under which option? Green shoe option. That is known as up to, they will give real example. You have to pick up that. 1.5 you remember. Over and above, not less than, in case of oversubscription. In case of undersubscription, that is known as underwriting. Okay. They want 5,000 crore. Supposing they have got only 4,000 crore, who will give the 1,000 crore? The primary dealer or the merchant banker, they will give the difference. That is known as what? Underwriting function. This is green swap option, mean issuing more share. How much more share? 15%. Sometimes they are asking. Now these concepts, very often, every question, they are supposing this month, this half year they are not asking, next half year they will ask. M0, M1, M2, M3, M4. And which is not included, which is included, they will try to test you. And sometimes they will give numerical problem also. What is M1? This is known as narrow money, money in circulation. Okay, what is money in circulation? The money in circulation that is in the hands of the public, plus whatever deposits you have got with the Reserve Bank of India and other deposits, Reserve Bank of India, current account, over and CRR balance, all these are known as what? M0, not MO, M0. Why they are calling zero? Technical term. M0 means it's a definition. They will give you some numeric also. M1 means our demand deposit, CASA will be added. Demand deposit mean plus, normally it is treated as what? M0 plus all liquid deposits of the banking system. That is, liquid means what? CASA, current account and savings bank. This is M1. The definition, not the definition they will ask, they will give you twisted question. M2, what is M2? M1 is known as narrow money, not M0. M1 is known as narrow money. The M0 is called as reserve money. Please remember, reserve money or floating money. Okay, but this M1 is known as narrow money. Okay, M2, what is M2? Here, post office deposit and all will not be included. In M1, post office deposits are not included. Either SP, savings bank post office, time deposit post office, even NSE. Or NSE doesn't come under M1, M2. NSE, no, national savings certificate will not come in any of the M1, M2, none of the above. NSE will not come in any of the M1, M0, M2, M3. So M2 different. Okay, M2 mean M1 plus post office current account. Post office demand deposit. Post office will not normally, they will not maintain current account. Only savings bank demand money. So M1 plus demand deposit. Demand deposits of all the post offices all over the country is known as M2 money. Okay, friends. M3 money is, again, post office deposit will not be included. M1 plus time deposit will be included. M1 already, our CASA is included. Now our time deposit included means it becomes M3. This is known as broad money. Okay, they will give you every question earlier they were asking. Okay, so be prepared. They will give live example and you have to compute the total. You have to know the definition, then you calculate plus minus you do. All plus only, M3, just to pick up money in circulation, plus all this with RBI, with current account, they will give in a twisted way. And the time deposit, you plus total all this, you will get M3 answer. Understood? M4, what is M4? M3 plus all time deposit related post offices, including recurring deposit. And important, M4 doesn't include NSE or post office. NSE and IMF borrowing, all these are not included in money. This M1, M2 is no economic indicator, how much money in circulation. Okay, these are the basic economic theory, how to calculate money supplier. This also 1 year they have asked. What is money supplier? Is money multiplier, not money supplier. Money multiplier is equal to formula you note down. M3 divided by M0. They will give example. Therefore, M3 is equal to M0 into money multiplier. Correct, you know? Money multiplier is equal to M3. M3 will be more. And divided by M0, which will be more, M3 will be more, divided by M0. So money multiplier, reserve money into, this is also known as reserve money. Reserve money into money multiplier is known as broad money. They will twist you in any way. M3 is known as broad money. Okay, M1 is known as narrow money. Some names, nomenclature they are given. Understand this, they will ask questions. Okay, friends? Okay. And here, question number 39. Bank can raise unsecured overnight borrowing. They will give answers. pick up the correct one. CBLO, no, CBLO is secured. You have to give security, otherwise gold loan. Gold loan is a secured loan. Without gold, they will not get, nobody will give you loan. So CBLO, security based. Call money, no security. Depot window, security. Either B or C, the answer is B. Because these two are secured. So like that, one question, but they will twist it. Agreed? 40. Oh, don't worry, 40 is coming afterwards. I have shifted. Which is not an impact on account of reduction in SLR. If you know that, which is not an impact, which is not an impact, which is an impact, which is not an impact on account of reduction of SLR. First, you should know what will be the impact in reduction of SLR. When SLR is reduced, you know, more funds will be available. You read the option carefully. Number one, funds for lending going up. Okay. Funds for lending, which is not an impact. Which is not an impact. It's an impact. Funds for lending will go up. You see the question, which is not an impact. So one is not correct. When SLR is ready, you will get more funds. Banks will. Money in circulation going up. Yes. When banks are able to lend more, money will go up. Investments will go up. Three. Investment activity is going up. True. It's not it's an impact. Okay. The question is, you see, not an impact. Interest earnings of the bank go up. Yes. True. Why? Because you are giving more loan. You are money, your activities. So, correct. Fifth one, hike in interest rate charged by the bank. This is the thing you have to understand. Which is not an impact on account of reduction in SLR. When SLR reduced, what will happen? Banks will have more money. Now, SLR, CRR rates are coming down or going up? It is coming down. Sorry, SLR is coming down. Earlier it was 25, sometimes those days, I remember 26% when we joined the bank. Now progressively reduced. Okay, now it is reduced to what? Even some apex banks are completely developed countries. No, there is no SLR. You will be happy. Banks will be happy. Why? Zero SLR means banks will be happy. Okay, because you can lend, you need not have to block your money in SLR instrument. That is all analytical thing. Now, the five is the correct answer, which is not an impact. Mean when the bank is with more money, interest rate will come down. It will not go up. Okay, so the correct answer is cost of funds for bank going up. No, when SLR is reduced, no, you will get the money. So answer is, oh, sorry, six also cost of funds for the bank going up. No, because SLR reduced mean banks will get more money. You need not have to go to the market. Your own deposit you are getting back because SLR is reduced. So the cost of funds for bank going up is not an impact. Please remember, which is not an impact, impact, very often they will lose. So you go through the six option, five and six is correct. Okay. I am not telling all the six options will not come. For understanding, I have given all the four possible option. For the exam, they will try to test you. Okay. Understood the concept mean? They will not. Okay. 45. What rate a bond of 1,000 rupees face value carrying 6.52 remaining maturity 2 years. Friends, they will try to test you. What rate a bond 2020-30. 2020-30 means 10-year bond. They will never tell 10-year bond. They will only tell 2019-29 means 1924, mean 5-year bond. They will use these words. What rate a bond of, here they have not used the tenor, full tenor they have not told, but remaining maturity 2 years. Simple, don't worry. 1000 divided by 1.0612 to the power 2. Remaining maturity 2 years mean remaining maturity. Don't get confused. Sometimes they will twist you. Rate the bond of 1000, 10-year maturity, face value having the coupon rate 6.12, remaining maturity 2 year can be purchased today. So don't get confused, sir. 10-year bond, just to twist you, they will add such words. Okay, just to confuse you. How many years are remaining? 2 years remaining. What is the face value? 1000. What is the coupon rate? 6.12. Divided by 1.0612 to the power 2. You are getting the answer. Okay, getting the answer. You have to discount twice. How to discount twice? I think all of you are familiar with the calculator. 1000 first you put, divide by 1.061 you put, equal to you put, one answer you will get. One more equal to you put, you will get this answer. One more equal to you try, again you don't have to divide. To the power mean it will be in memory, equal to 887.98. Agreed? 46. What is the yield rate in a bond goes up? Which of these will be true? They are the twisters. When the yield rate in a bond goes up means which of these will be true? Yield rate goes up means what? Yield rate goes up means coupon rate will be, yield rate goes up means bond price will come down. Remember, yield rate goes up means price will come down. If you know that concept, you can answer. Market rate goes up? No. A bond yield rate in a bond goes up. Okay. Market value of the bond goes down, either one or two? No. Answer is depend on the market situation. No. Answer is true. When the yield rate goes up, market rate will come down. When the yield rate comes down, market price will move up. Opposite. Both are opposite.
Murugesh sir. Excuse me, it's already 10 o'clock. I want to know whether they want to continue or not, because
good question.
Continue.
Another 16 questions are there. Maximum another 20 minutes. Now I think you have picked up speed. Maximum another 20 minutes. You are prepared to mean?
For me, it's okay, sir. But
yes. This presentation he will share with you, but
presentation
part will be missing. But the stage-wise description, we have already shared with. We will share with you. Don't worry.
Should we continue or not? You just give us a word. I will go with the majority. But if I am continuing, wait. If I am continuing, all those who are remaining, the remaining people should be there till then. Okay.
Yes, sir. Sure.
Give me a thumbs up, then I will okay. Okay. Good.
46, you understood. Now 47. Now we will pick up speed. When the bond is quoted at a discount, these are the questions they are asking in interview also. Even for executives interview, they are asking, believe it or not. When the bond is quoted at discount, which of these will be true? Which of these not true? True. When the bond is quoted at discount, please remember the price, it is the yield rate will be, the quoted discount will be, yield rate will be more than the coupon rate. You remember. Yield rate will be more than the coupon rate. This is the answer. But the answer, they will twist you. Yield rate is more than the coupon rate. Correct. Coupon rate is more than the yield rate. No. Yield rate only more than the coupon rate. That's the correct one. Either situation one or two, no. Only situation two is correct. It is coupon rate is more than. So the answer is one only. Answer is one only. Okay, friends. You have to eliminate carefully the choices. Multiple choices will be there only to twist you. Understand the concept. You will not be twisted. Let them twist, but don't get twisted. Cash management bill, CMB, is a popular instrument. It's nothing but a treasury bill, but with it's not a standard treasury bill. Standard treasury bill, 3 maturities. Doesn't mean non-standard. Non-standard mean occasionally they are issuing this short-term treasury bill also, but RBI only will issue. For maturity, description part, maturity will be less than 91 days. Okay, this will qualify for SLR. But it is not a less than, no. Normally, it is not considered as an open market operation. It's only a temporary measure to help the government. Okay, 49, auction of treasury bill, settlement will be on. The terminology you have to remember. Suppose in treasury bill, normally, it is auctioned on Wednesday. Settlement will be Thursday, next working day. So that is known as what? T plus 1 basis. T plus 0 means same day, remember. T means transaction date. T plus 0, T plus 1. This is a terminology they will use. Question very often they are asking, don't get confused. T plus 0 means same day. Transaction day, same day settlement, ready deal. T plus 1 means next working day. Treasury bill, government bonds are on T plus 1 basis, not T2, T3. So the answer is T1. T plus 1 mean next working day. Very often asked question, friends. Don't get confused. Okay. registry deposit for data security. Data security mean always issued by Government of India. Please remember, data securities mean Government of India will issue, okay, a bond with the definite maturity date. That is known as what? Data security mean the date of maturity will be pre-decided. Date of issue, date of maturity, and what is the registry? Where it will be reflected? In whose books? It is a PDO. PDO mean Public Debt Office, not SEBI, not NSDL. NSDL will issue shares only. And post office, no. This is a PDO, Public Debt Office of RBI. This is the registrar, registry. Okay, for shares, I think all of you know NSDL, CDSL, Central National Security. Okay, so this is a 5th question, easy. Easy question also sometimes they are asking. At what cutoff rate? This is the rate, this is the question very often being asked. What is the cutoff rate? The word they will twist you. An investor can bid in an auction 91 day treasury bill, face value 1000. The expected yield is 7.1 and per annum. So first convert to 91 days. So 7.12 divided by 365 multiplied by 91, 1.775. You understand? Step will be little different. Okay. Yearly interest is 7.12. 91 days interest is, this is the question, very often popular question. 1.775. Now 1000 divided by 1.01 is the one interval. PV is equal to PN divided by 1 plus R to the power N. Here N is only 1. So 1000 divided by 1.01775, 982 days. At a rate, with the rate, they will try to test you at a rate not exceeding 982.56. What is the auction? Don't auction for 985, then your yield rate will be less. If you are able to auction for cutoff mean, don't exceed 982. Cutoff mean, don't go beyond that rate. Agreed? 982.56, not exceeding is the answer. 52. What is the prudential limit for borrowing? Scheduled commercial bank in call money market. There are four limits you remember. Call money market, cooperative bank different limit, scheduled commercial bank different limit, primary dealer different limit. The chart will be there. Look at the chart before going to. Here I am sharing only. If you want to share, I think sir will help you. Okay. And here I am sharing only crash mean. Only important, very often asked question, you see the question, and on fortnightly, prudential limit for borrowing, all banks, each bank, how much I can borrow from call money market, is there any limit or no limit, because these are unsecured borrowing, no, you cannot borrow any amount, how much you can borrow, 100% on any peak day, peak day 125% peak day means what? On your peak day means Friday. Normally peak days will be Friday. Average 100, peak day 125. These limits you remember. For lending, for investing, 25-50. On a peak day, 50% you can invest. Average 25%. Okay. Primary dealer different. For cooperative bank, different. Cooperative bank, no tier 1, tier 2. Cooperative bank can borrow from call money market not exceeding 2% of their deposits. 2% of their deposits. Deposit mean NOF, net owned funds. Okay. So for cooperative bank, borrowing limit is there. For investing, no limit. So these things you keep in mind, one question will be there. Then one more question they will ask is marginal standing deposit. Because these are the words. The some fancy words, you know, always there will be question. What a marginal standing facility mean? Over and above repo reverse repo, Reserve Bank of India is helping them. The repo reverse repo, the window will be open only for limited hour. Okay, I think 10:30, 11:30, the timings are there. That also they will ask question. When is the repo window will open? When it will close? CBLO window also will open. You have to go to that, you know, that during that window, because it will not be open throughout the day. So the marginal standing facility mean, I think all of you know, standby facility. stand by loan to MSME unit. What is stand by loan? Just to help them. Over and above the sanction limit, the branch manager has is equipped with power, stand by loans. Similar way, marginal standing facility mean over and above your repo. Okay, what you can borrow from Reserve Bank of India, yes, based on some security, that is known as what? Marginal standing facilities administered by RBI, not by others. How much you can borrow, that is also up to 3% now of the NDTL. Marginal mean over and above your normal powers. Okay, 18 always, 18 you cannot buy. Another 3% under what? Supposing you have got more securities. Okay, under marginal standing facility, how much you can borrow? Marginal standing facility, when it is applicable, when you cannot go under the normal window, you can go under this window. And for this borrowing, the rate of interest will not be repo rate, something will be 0.25 will be more. Please remember, 0.25% will be more. Repo, reverse repo, that administered rate. For MSF facility, because beyond, you know, something beyond the normal working hour, normal working, they will charge you little more, 0.25. Earlier they were charging, it is effective from March 27. Up to 3% of your NDTL, you can go under MSF. Okay, they will give you twisted answer also. Your bank has got NDTL, 18,000 crore. How much they can borrow under MSF? These are the indirect question they will ask. This is a direct question, indirect question. Agreed? So 54 you go through. Now treasury also means risk management. Treasury risk management. You see, your treasury manager has an asset portfolio. One day where mean value at risk. 10 crores is having a portfolio of 10 crore. But 95% confidence level. One day varies 10 crore. One day value at risk is 10 crore. In a year time, year mean 365 days, horizon, with the trading days 280, how many times the loss on the portfolio may exceed 10 crore? Okay, so now you have to use symbol, it's not a formula. 95% confidence level mean, remember, is a technical word. 95% confidence level mean 5% you may lose. Okay, the uncertainty level is 5%. Confidence means up to 95 you are confident. This is a statistical term. So 5%, 5 days out of 100 days, the portfolio may exceed the 10 crore level. Okay, so 5 days, 95 mean out of 100, every 100 days, 5 days. Now how many trading days? 280 days. 5 days for 100, 280 days, 14 days. So the answer is simple question, but people are getting confused. Even without calculator, you can do, but you have to understand logically how many days the loss will. Okay, here no formula. 5 days out of 100, 280 days trading, how much? Simple question, one mark. 56. This volatility, one formula you have to remember. Assume a security held by a treasury manager, annual volatility 25. And if the active trading days are 250 days, what's the daily volatility? So now you have to remember the formula. The formula is month, the volatility is equal to, the rate of volatility is equal to, on the period's volatility into square root of time horizon. This formula you have to remember. What is the daily volatility, monthly volatility, fortnightly, sometimes weekly, sometimes, okay, weekly mean you have to 52 weeks, daily mean 365 days, monthly mean 12 months, 12 months in a year. See the question carefully, but formula is say, the rate of volatility is equal to volatility into square root of the time horizon. So 25 is equal to X, X you do not know, what is the daily volatility into square root of 25. Square root I cannot bring. So you have to start with square root of 25, divide 25 divide, if you divide, you will get what? 1.58. Okay, friends, this you go through one question, sometimes they are asking. Where in percentage? What is the where percentage is equal to the volatility? Volatility will be expressed per week, per day, per fortnight, per month. You have to see the question carefully and time horizon. Time horizon. It is expressed in week, square root of 52. It is expressed in month, square root of 12. expressing day square root of 365, but they will sometimes they will give the trading days. The basic value of a bond. This is also a question they are asking. What is basic value of a bond? 0.001. 1% is 100 points, remember. Now is a basis point. 40 points mean 0.40. 20 points mean 0.20. What is basis value? 1 point value. What will be the change in the price of a bond for one point change? 1% change is not 1 point is different. 1% is different. 1% mean 1 point mean 1/100. So you see the question. A 10-year 6 point simple question, but you have to remember. 10-year 6.5 bond has basic value of the bond 250. Basic value mean for 1 point, what is the value? 1 point change, 250 rupees will be up or down. The basic, the interest rate comes down, remember, price will go up. Interest rate goes up, price will come down. How much bond will gain or lose due to increase in the bond? Increase in the yield of the bond by 20 points. Increase in the yield mean price will come down. So 20 into 250. 1 point to 250 means 20 into 250 even by heart you can do. But you have to understand the concept mean one mark you are getting. So 20 into 250, 5,000 rupees is the, now it will be up or down. Increase in the yield mean price will be down. Increase in the yield mean price will be down. So the answer will be expected. Downfall in prices will be 5,000 rupees, the price will come down because basis value of the bond is 250. The 20 points mean 20 into 250. Okay, going up, coming down, you have to see the question carefully. Interest rate goes up mean the bond price will come down. Interest rate goes down, bond price, both are opposites. Market value and interest rates in respect of bond, both are opposite. Remember, it's a theorem. International theorem. Okay, so here the case study also they will give you, but I will not. I have given the work either. The one question will be there on duration analysis. Macaulay's formula. Macaulay is an economist and who invented a formula for calculating duration. What is duration? Up to what time you can hold the bond without being affected by interest rate. So the calculation I have given you, please remember. First, undiscounted cash flow is a 3-year bond with the cash flow. Bond I mean is a annual cash flow. So first year you will get 100 rupees, second year you will get 100 rupees, third year you will get 100 rupees, fourth year you will get, the third year end you will get the principal amount. Then you have to find out the discounted value at what rate. 10% and 1000 divided by 1.1 90, 1000 divided by 1.1 to the power 2, 100 divided by 1.1 to the power 3, 1000 divided by 1.1 to the power 3. So then you multiply with this, with this total also you do, you will get 1000 only. But this will be multiplied with the number of years. That is weighted. This is a formula for step by step duration analysis. We understand 1 mark here. Modified duration, you understand another 1 mark guaranteed. Okay. So the discounted value into multiplied by number of year, here 90, 82 into 64 into 2, 75 into 75.13 into 3, 751. They have added 2 into 3, so totally 2735.47 divided by undiscounted, that is that amount, then you will get 2.73. that will be expressed in duration. What does it mean? Though the 3-year bond, the period you can hold without being affected by interest rate is known as duration is 2.73. I have given the steps. One question last year, semi-annual, annual, they will try to, but formula is same. Okay, friends. Now next question, modified duration. MD. What is MD? Formula I remember. MD means modified duration. When is MD is required? Another calculation. One formula is there. What is the change? This is slightly technical. But if you understand, you are a scorer. Okay, you go through that. MD is equal to D divided by 1 plus R. D mean duration. MD mean modified duration. All Macaulay formula. Now, they are telling a zero coupon bond, but for a zero coupon bond, 5-year zero coupon bond mean you don't have to calculate duration like the way you have done earlier. It is always tenure of the bond, 5-year bond, zero coupon mean, don't calculate that way. Only that formula is applicable only for coupon, regular coupon, yearly coupon, semi-annual coupon, only you have to go apply that formula. If that is zero coupon mean, straight away the duration of the bond is equal to the tenure of the bond. Okay, but modified duration is a zero coupon bond, is a you see B is a zero coupon bond. So 5 years divided by 1 plus R. 1 plus R means what? 1 plus 0.9. So 4.587 years is the MD for this bond B. Okay, friends. So these are the, I think we have come up to 59. Another 2 questions only. This I will share with you. Always there will be one question on OTM. Know the formula. What is OTM? OTM normally they will ask for bonds with regular cash flow. Okay. What is a OTM? At what rate the future cash flows when discounted will become exactly equal to the present value. It is really calculated a different way. For CIB, one approximate formula is there. What is the approximate formula? OTM is equal to C. C means cash flow plus FV, future value, minus present value, divided by number of years, divided by average. Average. Now the question is bond A. What is bond A? Face value 1000. Today 940. 3 years tenure. So what is the difference? 60 rupees difference. What is the C? C is 1000 rupees, 10% mean 100. 100 C plus F minus PV. F minus PV is 60. 60 divided by 3 is 20. So 120 divided by 970. Have I got 970? Average. 970 is the average. So 12.37 is the yield to maturity. This is the approximate formula. Okay. You select the nearest one mark. OTM, one question will be there. But you use this formula. Okay, friends. But the real situation, they will use a different formula. Okay, here 60 question, technical. If the prices of security go down, the prices of securities, bond, share, anything goes down, who will gain? Who will gain? Seller will never gain. Don't worry. So, 1 and 3 ruled out. 2, buyer of put option. No, put option means selling. When the securities go down, it will be profitable to buy. Please remember. When the prices are going down, an investor will try to buy. So, the buyer of a call option. 4th is the correct answer. Technical question, 1 mark. Why you lose? Agreed. 60. 61 over. I think another just another half minute only. E-platform is always E-Kuber. Not E-Sanjit. E-Kuber is the platform for trading. Okay. NDS is different. This is only for government securities. The E-Kuber is, that is for all other securities. But government securities will be traded only in E-Kuber. It's a separate platform. NDS is for other securities also. But E-Kuber is for only for government securities. It's a platform, portal. A long-term repo means more than 1 year. What is the advantage? Banks are able to get long-term funds from RBI at a cheaper rate, administered rate. That's the advantage of, is the cost of funds will be lower. Up to 3 years, cost of funds are lower for, what is the impact they will ask? What is the impact of LTRO? LTRO means long-term repo. Long-term repo administered only by RBI. Okay, that tenure is up to 3 years. Okay, friends, normal repo is up to 1 year, but this repo is up to 1 to 3 years. Thank you very much. I have exactly finished 10:20. This will be shared with all.